Hey, thanks for coming to this page and checking us out. I'm going to give you my top three. The video, I'm going to explain a few things, so it's going to be a little more in-depth. But if you want to get the main top three, just go ahead. You can read down below. But please, I encourage you to listen to me and watch this video as it really gets to the details of just what the three reasons are. Okay, and there is a special offer on the bottom, but don't worry about that yet. I want to talk to you first. Okay, so here's the thing. 2020, here's my story. I'm going to tell you about how we got here, why we're doing this, and why we've continued. So in March of 2020, just before February, we moved into our brand new spacious location, beautiful facility in downtown Homestead across from City Hall on Washington Avenue. And we were doing phenomenally well. We enjoyed it. We loved the new place. It was beautiful. It was pretty. And then 3 weeks later, we were shut down due to the COVID-19. It just happened. I mean, it was just bound to happen. We got right away, we went from being here to immediately being cut in half and losing half of our members for various reasons. And it was a letdown, sure enough. But the one thing we decided to do is we have to service the people who are still with us. We have to help them. Now, we couldn't do physical classes for about 6 weeks. So what we did is went right to virtual. We got the kids involved, even adults, everybody, into physically training via Zoom, okay? Now, interestingly enough, I had been on Zoom for a few years already doing various seminars and webinars, to be exact. And so I was familiar with Zoom, and I was happy to see that it was a familiar process for everybody, so they came in. And we did our best, you know, we trained kids, we met them 3 to 4 times a week. I even did some private lessons with some. And after 6 weeks, we realized we had to make a change and bring people in. And I'm going to tell you, one of the things that we've noticed, we all used to complain about kids being on a tablet too long, right? But then that was nothing compared to what happened after the pandemic hit us. You know, they were on tablets for 10 hours a day, and you could see the burnout. So after 6 weeks, we decided that we had to get people physically in the studio. And we talked to the city, we talked to health organizations, and we found a plan that got people to physically train. And it was a little slow start, but thankfully, after the summer and into the fall, we started to see the changes and the positive feedback we had. And these three reasons I'm going to give you, it's not just my top three, it's what parents have told me. I'm sure you've heard the same things from other people. So let me get to it. So number one, the top reasons that I feel your child needs to be in a martial art program, especially now, is human interaction. Okay, now we talked about them being on that tablet too long and being totally like immersed in electronics. And it's gotten to the point where they just didn't know what a human being was anymore. So when they came to the studio, there was a little lag. When they start physically training, there was a little bit of a delay. And I know we've seen that with schools, right? The schools, students, when they started to get back, there was a learning delay, and it did affect them. So the human interaction, talking to a human being, I could do whatever I can do this way, and it works, but it's not a permanent solution. It's meant to be a temporary fix, and eventually you need that person in front of you to motivate you, to coach you. It's the facial interactions. It's the body movement. It helps, especially with children, in their focus, in their courtesy, and their discipline. Okay, so human interaction, number one. Number two, physical fitness. Let's be honest. You know, a lot of people gained weight when they went into lockdown, and I was able to keep some of them off from that. They didn't gain as much because we kept them active every day, but when they came back to the studio and we could ramp up those workouts, those kids got more fit, they felt better. Their parents told me, man, they go to bed easier now, they wake up better. We've missed the physical training, and we do focus on fitness here in the studio for every class because we feel it's important, and we always say you got to be fight to fit or to defend yourself. So you got to be fit. So to fight, you got to be fit, and you got to be fit to fight. So fitness. Number three, most important one, is I feel to me it's the most important one because it helped me when I was a kid. Socialization, okay? Now, socialization doesn't sound like a big deal, but one of the things that was very painful to watch while I was teaching kids on Zoom is the first week, I remember this, we met 3-4 times a week. Now, mind you, we were out for about a week and a half getting ready for Zoom. Some schools started later than us, but we were kind of a little ahead. We knew what we were going to do. And so for a week, the kids weren't in school. Those kids had not seen their friends. So it was a little tough. And when I turned on Zoom, let's say at 5:30 for my class, and all the kids started talking to each other, and I couldn't get them to stop. And I told the parents, you know what, let's let them have 10 minutes. Let them have 10 minutes to talk to each other. They haven't seen each other in about 2 weeks. And they started just chit-chatting. And that was probably the most important part of my class on Zoom, was letting them chit-chat for 5 to 8 minutes. And I said, okay, let's start. Let's do our warm-up. Let's do our class. And then let them go. And then that was the hard part, because they also missed me. They missed their friends. They missed other friends. So socialization is how humans develop. So when those kids came back to the studio and they could talk to me, to the other staff, to the other kids, and sometimes they don't even see each other in schools, because some of them still aren't in physical school. So they come over here and they just talk and catch up. And that's very important for children. And I see that the more and more we don't let them interact and socialize, the more and more we're going to get into some problems later on in life. And we don't want this to be the norm. We want the norm to be socialization and human interaction. All right, those are my top three. Now on the bottom, you know, go ahead and check out the special offer. We do have our schedule up there for kids. And we also have our $20. It's less than 20 bucks. Our trial offer includes a uniform. Give it a try. If you don't feel satisfied with us, there's 100% money back guarantee. All right. I hope you take advantage of it. If not, thank you for listening to me. And I look forward to seeing you guys. If you have any questions, call or text me. I'll be happy to answer them for you. Have a great one.